Not like the burger!
What's up, crew, and welcome to another bit of a tutorial video. So many of you keep rocking and asking me to do bag work tutorials for beginners. I have done these, but I'm gonna do it again, with some different combinations. So you're gonna be able to go back and watch the originals. There's some 300 punch workouts and some technique stuff. I'll link them all in the description. But today what we're gonna do is show you how to build up combinations and throw some correct punches so you can get a good cardio workout in on the bags. And this, again, is not about being a fighter. It's not being rough and tough or hard or looking good. It's just about doing good technique to get the heart rate pumping, get those lungs blowing out, and making you push through boundaries. So let's take a quick look at what you need to start doing this. Number one, you're gonna need some gloves. 12-ounce gloves are usually a safe bet. They're a good all-round glove that you'll be able to use if you decide to go to classes or want to do the bags, because they're going to protect your hands enough so you're not smashing up your knuckles, but they're going to add a little bit of weight to your arms to make you work. So a 12-ounce glove, if you want to make it tougher, go 14 to 16 ounces. Underneath those, some little handy wraps are always a good idea. I've got these RDX gel pad ones, which you can see and smell, they've been used quite a lot. But these are cheap and cheerful. You can get them from Amazon or any good online store. And they've got a nice wrist wrap on there for protection. So that's always gonna be good. And the gel helps protect those knuckles, and they sit nice and tight under your gloves like a wrap would, which is gonna inspire confidence on those shots.
Down here.
Yeah. Footwear. This is my go-to one for you guys, just if you want to get something you'll be able to use in the gym or on bag work. These are Lonsdale boxing boots. I think they're called Hurricanas or something like that. There's a few models. They're about £35 from like Sports Direct or somewhere like that. Just Google Lonsdale boxing boots. They're all really decent. They're cheap, they're cheerful, and they will take a licking and keep on ticking. There's no need to be spending copious amounts of money on this to be able to just jump in and get a good cardio workout. And the final most asked about thing is the round timer that I use to do my rounds. It's shockingly called round timer.
Mother.
Yeah, it's that simple.
Crazy.
It's like round timer into the app store, and this little beauty will pop up. It's simple, it's perfect for what we want to do. It allows you to give rest points, your full round times, and the amount of rounds that you want to do. Now, I opt for 60 seconds when you start out. You want around 60 seconds between your rounds. I tend to do 3-minute rounds. Then as you want to get a bit fitter, you can reduce that rest time down to 30 seconds, or you can up the total number of rounds that you do. Just start out doing 3 3-minute rounds with a minute's rest in between, see how you feel, and add them on as you go. Now, this is personal preference. At the moment, I've got on my Gymshark Legacy old school tank, and I kind of like these for chilling out in, so I don't want to fuck it up and make it sweaty. But what I do want is a little bit more movement and freedom, because this is going to get hard. You are going to sweat a lot, so I will warn you, you might need to take a change of top when you start implementing this into your workout. So I'm going to switch to this, which is the Legacy drop arm, because it's going to give me a little bit more movement, and it's just a little more comfortable. It's what I like to wear. So 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. Now I've got a nice little bit of range of movement. I can get a little bit sweaty. Let's get started. Quick little recap on how we're gonna be throwing our punches. If you're new to the bag work, this is a really simple technique to make sure you're throwing them right, and you're gonna reduce the risk of twinging and twanging your joints. What we're gonna look to do, first off, is set our feet right. Now I'm right-handed, which means my left hand is my forward hand, my leading hand. If you are left-handed, chances are your right side is going to be your leading hand and you're a southpaw, which means you're a bugger to fight if it ever comes down to it. So it's not so much of a bad thing. But for me, it's my left, which means my left leg goes forward. What's going to happen then? I'm going to keep my weight on my back foot, and that back foot, the heel is going to stay up and I'm going to stay loaded. That's where I'm going to drive from. Now, to make sure that what we're going to do is not hurt our elbows or shoulders, we don't want to be punching with our elbows low coming through, because there's going to be a lot of tension and torsion flexing through that elbow, plus we're going to lose a lot of power on the punches. Same goes for jabs, we don't want it low. So to make sure we don't do that, we're gonna turn the punch over as we throw. What I mean by that is, as you throw from the chin, you're gonna roll that fist over. So we're not punching straight out like this, we're gonna roll it over. Then you're gonna return back to the chin to throw the right hand, same things happen, comes out, rolls over, and boom. So you can see straight away what's happening. I'm loading that back foot, I push off the back foot, you can see that shoulder's coming up, that's protecting my chin. I've got a nice long reach. As I return, same thing happens. I extend, roll over, and by rolling over, that brings my shoulder into that nice protective stance. Left hand is up, and I'm driving through that back foot, rolling through with my hips. So we end up with this really nice, smooth punching motion. 1, 2. Yep. Now slow things down. Don't try to go too fast on this. Don't just try and come in like Bruce Lee. Take your time. Land them, practice them and just throw nice and slow. This is all a big learning curve for a lot of us, and it doesn't matter. Again, like I said, it's not about looking cool or looking hard or looking tough. It's about doing this right, getting a good cardio workout in, and making that muscle work. So combination work. I'm going to show you three combinations here that you're able to do on their own independently, but you're also going to be able to lace them in one after the other and build up some nice long combination work. As you will have seen in the previous video I did with Owen Roddy, it's just building on that same concept of starting with one combination and then adding in the others over the top as you get more comfortable. So, combination one. So everything we do, we're going to have our hands up, we're going to be at least at chin height. If we're boxing only, we're going to want to be quite high guard. So what I don't want to see, so once you're throwing your punches, is the hands to drop. Think about always coming back to the chin, whatever. If you mess up once, it doesn't matter, stop and reset. So combination one is going to be a real nice simple one to get you into that groove of turning that punch over and landing them at distance. We're going to go one, two, and then we're going to throw the left jab again and step back out of range. So we're stepping in, one, two, step away. At speed, pop, 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 and then we're out of range. And what we're coming in, so we're striking, and then that we're giving them a going away present as we step back out of range and into safety. Hands up at all times. Pop, 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 guard. Combination two. We're gonna start again with that jab. This is our nice little setup for most combinations you're gonna do. So we're gonna come jab, then we're gonna come down with a power straight right down the center. As we bring that, we're gonna slip to the right, and then double up with that straight right. So, from distance, we're safe. We're gonna step in, pop, pop, then we're going to slip right, and then bang, strike again with that power right. Done at a relative pace, nice and easy. Pop, pop, slip, bang. The important thing to notice here is the feet. So as we've thrown that second punch, as we roll, we're going to step across with the right foot, roll under, follow back with the left, then that lotus up here to hit that straight right. So bang, bang, step, roll, straight. Notice this left hand is kept up all the time through those rags. Combination number three, your final combination for today, is a little bit of a sneaky one. You're going to be hitting on the move. So we're going to be striking the body as we step across. So same thing as before, stepping across with that roll, but this time what we're going to do is we're going to hit the body as we do so. So imagine that someone's throwing a left hook at you, you're going to be rolling under, and you're going to be catching, coming through with a left body shot. As you roll back up, then you're going to come through, you're going to come straight right, left hook, straight right, and then get out the way. So what you'll be doing is moving around the bag, and then we're gonna mimic that hook. As the hook comes, what we're not gonna do is lean forward. We're gonna drop our weight. We're gonna then swing through with that hook, keeping the right guard up. As we step through, roll, step, swing, bang, into the body. As we then come through and up, we're gonna load on that back foot, straight right, left hook, straight right, keeping that elbow high on the hooks. So here we go, moving around. Whenever you're ready, roll, bang, 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 and then step away. So you can make it nice and smooth. Really, you see that left hook coming, whoosh, 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 and out the way. So how do we make these into a workout? So you're going to be doing your 2 to 3 minute rounds. If you're really new to this and you're really tired, you can do minute rounds, that's absolutely fine. Or you can do minute rounds and just do high speed. There's no real wrong way of doing this. We just want work and output. But what I would say is, throw the combinations independently. Get used to throwing them nice and slow until you feel a nice rhythm with them. Once you start feeling a rhythm, start thinking ahead of what you're gonna throw. So start building combination one into combination two, or combination two into combination three, and start just having those numbers in your head, one, two, three, of what combination you're gonna throw. Because when you're doing the workout, when you get tired, often when you get tired, if you don't have a plan, you end up just throwing nonsense and throwing bad shots. If we have combinations to hand that we're used to throwing, and we've got a good mechanism for, then as soon as you get tired, you can just go, come on, 2-2, or 1-1. And we're doing, you know, so if we're shouting 1-1 and we're tired, we can go, bang, 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 whoo, bang, 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 whoo. And it just keeps us on track. It keeps us focused, like reps on a set. It's the same with the boxing. You need that focus and you need that challenge. The big one, though, is string them all together in a 1-2-3 combination to finish your rounds nice and strong. So what that would look like, we're moving around the bag, and we've done our singles, one, boom, we've moved away. We've come in, maybe we've done a three, boom, bang, 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 moving around the bag again. We've done a combination two, we're getting good with that nice little slip and pop and bang, and it's coming to the end of the round, and now we're gonna finish strong, so we're gonna do one, two, three. And you're just gonna flow, don't try and rush it, but just build them up as you go. So, one, boom, step away, then we step back in, pop, pop, slip, bang, roll, boom, pop, pop, pop. And then you can slowly speed those up. Pop, 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 boom, pop, pop, shot.
Yeah, go and play that. Set you down, I'ma say that. Mining me a couple dollars. Telling you now this payback. So I take that. Ask them now, we'll say that. I've been going to the top and I got what they not, so I know that they hate that. But I'm on now. All these lanes gonna zone out. And all these lanes gonna take what I did and they twist and they worse till I fall out.
And there you go, you have a really nice three-part combination that you can stick one after the other that ends up in a nice, I don't know what is that. A 10 punch combination, something like that. Don't know, didn't count it beforehand, but it looks pretty cool and it makes you feel the flow, getting to use the moving, it makes the body move, and you're ending with something that's gonna feel good but be working everything from those lats, shoulders, triceps, core, plus lungs, heart and cardio. So give it a go. 1 minute rounds, 3 minute rounds, running those combinations, sorting them in singles, moving around, repeating them, and then doubling them up, tripling them up, and then finally putting them all together. I hope this has given you a good idea of what you need to start a beginner's workout on the bags. Don't be afraid to get up there. Don't be put off by the fact there's other people up there looking serious. This is hard. It's tiring. You're going to be pulling an angry face for a long part of this workout, but it doesn't mean that people aren't there to be approachable or aren't there to help you. If there's somebody there, once they've done their rounds, then speak to them and ask them if you've got any questions. Just don't interrupt the mid-round and you'll be absolutely fine. I've been Lex. This has been another bag workout, circuit workout, muscle building, fat loss, wonderful journey of experience. And if you've got any questions, hit me in the comment section below. Make sure to hit that notification bell here, I think, and make sure to select all notifications so you don't miss any of my future uploads. Thanks for watching. Give it a big like if you made it this far. I'll catch you in the next one. Boom, baby.
Lately I've been doing shit different. Cooking like a chef, I've been all up in the kitchen. Had to make a move, had to make a little distance. A lot of people tripping, they could never see the vision. Fuck that, tell them bye.